Hi everyone, I am your host for today's Ollie Falls and Horses quiz part one. Me, Emma! So I've decided to do a Ollie Falls and Horses quiz throughout this month. So there's going to be four parts in this quiz. So let's move on to the next slide. All about the quiz. This quiz is all about the very well-known sitcom Ollie Falls and Horses, which was broadcasted on BBC One from 8th of September 1981 until 25th of December, Christmas Day 2003, which consisted of series and specials. In my opinion, it's the best sitcom ever to be on our screens. So let's talk more about the quiz. There will be three rounds on this quiz. Round one will be all about the main four characters of the Trotter family, who are Del Boy, Rodney, Grandad, and Uncle Albert, of course. We can't forget about him, can we? Round two will be a picture round where I will show you a picture of a character and you will name who this character is. The final round on this quiz is called Name This Episode, where I'll give out a description of an episode and you will write down what episode I was describing. Some of these questions will be from the Ollie Falls and Horses quiz book and some will be from myself. I hope you will all enjoy this quiz and have fun trying to remember. Also, before I move on to the rules of the quiz, if you want me to send a template sheet with how many questions in each round, I can do that. Just comment below on this YouTube video or message me on Facebook and Twitter and I will get that sorted out for you so you don't have to worry about looking for a pen and paper. Finally, if anyone wants to be involved in this quiz, this is going to be a competition. Who will get the most right on each quiz and be put on the leaderboard, and who wins the ultimate Ollie Falls and Horses quiz, they'll win a gift from me. Now it's time to get your brains working and enjoy. So the rules of the quiz. There's no cheating allowed from the internet. No, we don't want that. You can pause the video at any time to get a snack or a drink or whatever fits your fancy, really. Have a great time. It's a lot of fun, this quiz. It took me about 2 weeks to do this quiz. It's four parts, so it's going to take me a while. You can play on your own or with your family, your friends. And two of these rounds will have 10 questions. And the last one will only have 9. So get ready for the first round. And remember, have fun. So this is the round section about Del Boy Trotter. He's one of my favourite characters. Comment below, who's your favourite character of the main Trotter family? He's my favourite. I like them all, but he's my best one in Ollie Falls and Horses. So question one. Which actor plays the main role of Del Boy? Question two. What is Del Boy's middle name? Question three. What is Del Boy's famous line? Clue. Del Boy always says this in every season and special, which never happens until Time on Our Hands special. Question four. In May the Force Be With You episode, what Muppet character's name did Del Boy use as slang for the toilet? Question five. Which Ollie Falls and Horses special did he play as a double? Question 6. True or false? Del Boy is married to Raquel. So the picture put on top, that is from when they first met. That was dates. And the last picture at the bottom is the very last that special they did, which was Sleepless in Peckham. Question 7. What is the name of Del Boy's father? I'm only saying Del Boy because it's not Rodney's father. So it is revealed in the very last special that they are, in fact, I have brothers. Oh, Rodney fans out. Question 8. The first line Del Boy said in the very first episode. Question 9. The last line Del Boy said in the last special, not the comic relief special featuring David Beckham. What did everyone think about the David Beckham sketch one with the Fuzz and Horses? I did like it, but it's not as good as the Fuzz and Horses specials and the episode season, so. They were going to have a trigger in that comic relief special, but he died, I think it was a year before they did the special. And the final question in All About Del Boy Trotter. In the Jolly Boys Outing special, what did Del Boy say a female swan is called? That is the most funny scene in that special. I can't say what the answer is. It's what Rodney does. He says what it is. I'm not saying. Because I'll give her the answer. If you watch this scene, it's the most funniest one ever in that special. So this is all about Rodney Trotter. Again, there's 10 questions in section. So let's move on to question 1. One second. Okay. Which actor plays the main role of Rodney Trotter? Sorry about that. Marcel has a plane up. Yeah. Who plays the main role of Rodney Trotter? Question 2. What is Rodney's middle name? Who is Rodney married to? Question 4. What is the name of Rodney's real father? You can give me the nickname which was given or the full name of this character. So this character is played by the same guy as Rodney, as you can tell by his face. And both of these pictures are from the spin-off Rockin' Chips, where you find out more about his backstory. And you find out more about, is it John? Name, John. Whatever, Del Boy's real mum and Rodney's. Yeah, it's John, isn't it? John Trotter. John Mavis Trotter, I think it is. Well, you know, Bray's not looking today. How many GCE, GCSEs, or levels did Rodney pass at school? Question six. In what subject or subjects did Rodney obtain an O level? Question seven. In which episode did Rodney fall in love with a policewoman? Del wasn't happy. Question eight. In the Unlucky Winner Is episode, what age did Rodney have to pretend to be on holiday after winning the Mega Cornflakes competition? I love the bottom picture. What have you been doing? I've been skateboarding, Cassandra. Sarcastic. Sarcastic. Question nine. In Ashes to Ashes episode, can you recall Rodney's girlfriend? Now, this is the hardest question, this one. And the final question in this round is, what is the name of Rodney's daughter? She's cute, isn't she? Now, this section is all about granddad. Again, there is 10 questions in this section. Question one, which actor played the role of granddad? Question two, according to the spin-off Rockin' Chips, what is granddad's full name? The second picture is from Rockin' Chips, the younger granddad. And he was in the BBC soap EastEnders. Question three. How many series did Grandad appear in? Question four. What did Grandad turn black in the Christmas Crackers episode? Question five. How many televisions was Grandad watch at the same time? Question six. Name the last episode he appeared in before he and the actor died. Question seven. Grandad spoke the very first line in Only Fools and Horses. What did he say? Question eight. Where was Grandad born? Question nine. Grandad was arrested in two episodes. Can you name them both? And these two pictures are the clues. And the last question, all about Grandad, is how was Grandad related to Uncle Albert? Now, this section is all about Uncle Albert. So again, there's 10 questions in this section. Let's move on to question one. Question one. Which actor played the role of Uncle Albert? Question Question two. What is Uncle Albert's famous line? It annoys a lot of people, but it makes me laugh. Question three. In which episode do we see Uncle Albert for the very first time? Question four. The last Ollie Falls and Horses special he appeared in. I love the second picture. Can you guess what he's pouring over his Christmas food?
Oh, man.
Question five. Name the Ollie Falls and Horses special when we found out that sadly Uncle Albert passes away. Question six. What is Uncle Albert's middle name? Question seven. Name Uncle Albert's two brothers. How much money did Uncle Albert leave in his will to Dale and Rodney? I want the full amount, not what they got each, the full amount. Question nine. In Sleeping Dogs Lie episode, what did Uncle Albert take by mistake in place of his sleeping pills? And finally, what was his last line said in his very last Ollie Falls and Horses special? So if you want a break, you can pause this video. So like I said, you can pause at any time to get a snack or a beverage or whatever takes fancy. So round two is a picture round. So like I said, in this round, I'll be showing you 10 pictures of characters from the series and the specials. You just need to tell me the names of the characters they played, not the actor's name who portrayed them. So let's get on to picture one. Okay, so this picture is from series one. So I can give you a clue on this picture. She's one of Del Boy's ex-fiancées. Picture two. Can you name this policewoman that Rodney falls in love with in series two? Can you name Denzel's wife in series three? Picture four. This is one of Rodney's girlfriends. The clue. Could she be Del Boy's daughter? I just want to... I'm joking. I just want her name. So this picture is from series five, but can you name this woman? She is Trigger's niece. So can you name Cassandra's father from series six? It was in a lot of these specials, not a lot, but a few of them, I say. It was in a couple of series as well. And another picture from series 6. Can you recall this guy who has problems singing his R's? This picture is from the, is it Heroes and Villains special? Can you name this woman? And can you name this guy from the special Modern Men or Modern Man? I think it's Modern Men or Modern Man, any one of them. There's a fact about this actor played in. I didn't know he's a character out of Emmerdale as well, and I just realised. Oh, I can tell it's him now. Oh, no way. Mum just said he was in it. I was like, what? So yeah, he plays a character in Emmerdale as well. And that's him saying, I'll be back. I'll be back, Mr. Crotter. I think this is the final picture. So this is Raquel's father. Can you name him? So that round was over. So now it's the final round. What is the name of the episode? In the final round, I will be describing an episode from the series, and all you've got to do is answer what episode I am describing. Also, I'm going to make this bit tough. I am not going to put pictures on of the episode or any clues, like more clues. So get your brains working on this one. Good luck. So number one, Del Boys and Rodney's father turn up one Christmas at the flat. The boys' dad claims to be seriously ill and persuades the boys to have their bloods tested. The dad alters Del Boy's blood group, casting doubt that Del and Rodney have the same dad. Rodney and Granddad get on great with the new trotter, while Del Boy remains at a distance. The truth is revealed in the end, and Del sends him packing. Good riddance, I'd say. Okay, number two. One of Del Boy's old fiancés, Pauline, turns up at the Nag's Head. Del is smitten and falls in love with her over again. Later on, Del reveals that he and Pauline are getting married and also that she is going to live with him in the flat, which leaves Rodney and Grandad unhappy and decides it's time for them to leave. When Del discovers that Pauline has been divorced twice already, he decides to jump ship as well. The boys turn up at a house they believe is their aunt's house, only to discover that she has left many years ago. At the end of the episode, Granddad has a chat with a speaking clock in America. Number three, a trip to the Starlight Room see Del expanding his business interests, and he agrees to supply a cabaret act. Del persuades Raquel to team up with one of Trigger's old workmates, Tony Angelino, only to discover that Tony cannot sing any songs with R's in them. So Del Boy does a runner and leaves Rodney and Raquel to face the music. Number four, Del Boy just cannot win a game of cards and seems to have no luck at all. Then he decides to organise a poker night at the flat. Boysy turns up with a briefcase full of readies and dodgy deck or two. In the final hand, Boysy thinks he has Del to the cleaners, believing he has won the entire contents of the flat and Trigger's car by producing four kings. However, Del Boy has something up his sleeves and produces a poker of aces to win the game. Number five. In this episode, Del Boy agrees to purchase 250 18-carat gold chains from a retired jeweller. The chains aren't really exactly kosher, having avoided the clutches of HM Customs and Excise. Del puts a consortium together, compromising Uncle Albert, Rodney, Boysy, Trigger and Mike to purchase the chains, all to witness a former owner suffer an apparent heart attack in a restaurant. However, all is not lost as Del gets his money back after the jeweler attempts a con on Denzel. Number six. A stranger approaches Mike and books a room at the Nag's Head for a reunion of all his classmates from 1962. Del, Boyce, Trigger and Denzel are all invited and turn up, along with Rodney, only to discover that the evening was organised by the despised Roy Slater. However, Slater has just recently been released from prison and the boys give him a second chance. A good night's of drinking is had by all, only for it to end with Del discovering that Slater is Raquel's husband. Number seven. Del purchases a consignment of briefcases from Trigger, only to discover that no one can open them because the combination to each one is locked inside the cases. Grandad tells the boys about the time he was a night watchman at a leather factory and how he unwittingly allowed an employee to steal a few hundred briefcases by taking one home with him almost every night for nearly a year. This was also the first episode ever made and put the Trotters on their way to screen success. Eight. The boys are a bit strapped for cash until Uncle Albert falls down a hole. The hole in question is the cellar door of the Nag's Head, and Albert lands on Mike, the landlord. The brewery, often out of court settlement, but Del wants more and instructs a solicitor to take the matter to court. Of course, the boys lose their case after it is discovered that Uncle Albert had a history of falling down holes. I think this is the final one now. Del Boy purchases a consignment of paint from Trigger and persuades the local Chinese restaurant to have their kitchen painted. The only trouble is that after the paint dries, it is luminous and the kitchen staff have to wear glasses. Del discovers that the paint is used to paint signals in railway tunnels. To make matters worse, Del Boy paints his mum's statue with the paint, and now it lights up the entire graveyard. So that was the final three rounds. Thank you so much for taking part in this Silly Fools and Asses quiz part one. If you want to be involved in the competition, the quiz will end on the 8th of May, 2021. On the 10th of May, I will reveal the answers to this quiz. So if you can send me the answers through Facebook and Twitter, or you can email me the answers, I can do that for you. And I will do a leaderboard on the next video when I do the answers. So thank you very much if you're taking part. So if you're playing with family, friends, you can make a fun team name, a funny one or whatever you want to name your team. So yeah, there we go. I was the host. I don't know why I put narrator. I was the host, the creator of the quiz and designer. My other sister, Sarah, she was a question finder, helping find questions. And my other sister, Eleanor, who made the slide transition to another slide, you know what I mean? There we go. Thank you very much. And if you want to sing along at the end of the video, let me just get... my computer's a bit slow.
We got some off-price cracked ice, some miles of carpet tiles, TVs, deep freeze, and David Bowie LPs, pool games, gold chains, wuss names, and head a push, some Trevor Francis track suits from a mush and shepherd's bush. Bush, 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 bush. No income tax, no VAT, no money back, no guarantee. Black or white, rich or poor, we'll cut prices at a straw.
Again, thank you so much for taking part, and I'll get the other Fools and Horses part two quiz after I reveal the answers. Bye now, enjoy the rest of your week.